A lot of people forget that they have a choice of reaction. And proactive boundaries is about result. They based on the result that you would like to achieve. So reactive boundaries is when you react based on your emotion, and proactive is when you think first, what do I want to get from this situation, and then you choose your reaction. For example, at work, if there is a person who does not respect your space, who maybe can come and grab things from your table like pen, paper, stapler without asking, he might not even think that he is doing something disrespectful to you. Maybe he was raised in a family when they did not have any boundaries, when they can trust everybody at home, when you can take anybody's stuff, when you share everything together. It's like family without boundaries. We're so close that we don't have secrets, we don't have any walls, any boundaries between us. But maybe you were raised in a different family, and when a person is coming and just grabbing, you know, paper from your table, for you it's disrespectful, but for him it's normal. And if you're gonna confess him that you, if you're gonna tell him that what he did was rude, or how could he do this, this is not nice, this is not how it's supposed to be, if you're gonna blame him, then he might not even understand why are you angry or why are you reacting this way. So instead of blaming this person, you can tell him something like this. If you need anything, please just ask. I will be glad to share it with you. But when you just come and take stuff from my table, I feel disrespectful. I know it might be different for you, and maybe you did not mean to be rude towards me, but this is how I feel. It's very important to tell the person about your feelings. Instead of blaming him, you tell him how you feel. So this way, there is nobody's fault. When you use I statement, a lot of people will hear you. You will have a better chance to create a healthy boundaries, healthy relationship with your team at work. And often I see when the people can be great communicators at work, but when they come home, it's a totally different story. So at work, they know how to solve conflicts. They know how to protect their boundaries. But when they come home, their family members do not respect their time, do not respect their things. They do not respect your feelings. So this is also possible. Sometimes we know how to behave in one area of our life, but we don't know how to apply those same skills in other area of our life. But remember, you're not a child anymore. What was in the past is in the past, and now you can change your reaction. If you did not know, if your parents did not teach you how to communicate, how to protect your boundaries in a healthy way, then it means that for years you were developing reactive boundaries. And of course, it's not easy for you to switch like this and become, you know, the person, a great communicator who knows how to solve conflicts. Of course not. It's possible, but it will take time. And there are specific skills, there are specific techniques and specific exercises that you can do. And step by step, you will learn how to use words, how to be respectful towards others, at the same time protecting your own space, your own opinion, your own values. If you would like to learn how, if you have questions, please leave your comments below. And come to my private sessions where we can talk about your challenges, about your situation, and I can offer specific exercises for you and help you to develop healthy boundaries. And when you have a healthy boundaries, when you know how to protect yourself, then you can feel more confident, your self-esteem will go up, your self-confidence will go up, you will be more successful in your work, in your romantic relationship, in your friendship, and the life will be easier for you. You will reach your results faster, and you will be just a little bit happier and the life will bring more joy to you. So if you would like to come for the private sessions, all links will be below. Also, check out my other videos. I have separate playlists about the money, relationship, success, self-love, self-confidence. Everything will be linked below. If you find this video helpful, please click like, subscribe, and share. When I see your likes, when I see your comments and your questions, it makes me to create more videos. It motivates me, and I would like to share more videos with you. Let me know what topic would you like me to discuss next. You can write your questions below in the comment box. If you have anonymous question and you would like to ask me a private question, you can go on my website under a specific form where you can fill out your information and send me your private questions. Please share this video with your friends on Facebook, on Twitter. Help me to promote my channel. And of course, thank you for watching Psychology of Happiness, where happiness is the purpose of life.